Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making dark chocolate truffles. Actually, this is for Christmas. I've already finished up my Christmas table and shown that to you, so it might seem odd that I'm continuing on, but I felt like I needed to give you time to make those things if you were interested, so I wanted to upload it approximately a week ahead of Christmas, and then anything that I might think of that is Christmassy, I'll try to get uploaded before Christmas or maybe even after Christmas. That week is still part of the holiday season as we go toward New Year's. But these truffles are just really easy to make, and you can use them as gifts. You can just enjoy them on Christmas Eve, or sneak one now and then while you're watching TV. They're great. So I want to show you how to make them. We start with a large mixing bowl, and we put some chocolate in, and it can be the type of chocolate that you like, but I'm calling these dark chocolate truffles, and actually what I'm using is semi-sweet chocolate. So if I had had dark chocolate in my pantry, I would have used dark chocolate, but it's up to you. You can use semi-sweet, you can use milk chocolate, you can use white chocolate. So there's a whole range there that you can do. I'm using this container, which is 12 ounces worth. And we'll start by just placing those in our mixing bowl. Now I'm going to go to my heavy whipping cream. This is the heavy whipping cream that I'm using, but I don't need all of this. This is 1 cup, so I have taken another container and measured out 3/4 cup. And it's a little bit thick because it's still got ice crystals in it. I had it frozen. I bought it, I think, around Thanksgiving time and had more than I needed, so I just stuck them in the freezer. And they're usually really good if you need to whip cream because those little ice crystals help it to set. But I need to heat this, so I just had to be careful and measure out 3/4 of a cup. We'll bring it over to the stove and we'll use low to medium heat. And we'll bring it just to a boil. We won't let it bubble. We'll let it get to the point where it's just ready to bubble. And then I'll show you what we do with it next. Here is our heavy cream. It's just bubbling around the edges. That's what happens when you scald milk. It looks right like that. But you don't want rolling bubbles throughout. So I'm bringing it over and placing it on a mat and just letting it rest for a moment. Stir it around. Get it all smoothed out. And then what it's going to do is melt the chocolates. So we're going to be pouring this over our chocolates. It's very hot. Remember, it's 212 degrees if it is right at the boiling point. And I need to stir a little bit. And you can see that our chocolate will dissolve nicely. But this may take a while, so let me get it dissolved and then I'll come back and show it to you. I've been stirring the chocolate and the cream for maybe 2 or 3 minutes, and you might see a little lump here or there, but as I let this sit at room temperature for maybe an hour or so, those will dissolve. Now I have one more thing to add before I let this sit. Over here I have measured out 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. So I'm just going to put that in for some extra flavor. Stir it around. And you do want to wait until you've got your chocolate dissolved, otherwise it would cool it down a little bit, and you want all the effect of that heat from the hot cream so that you can get nice smooth truffles. But this is good enough. So we're going to let this sit at least an hour. Then we'll come back to it and start working on making truffles out of it. I did let my dark chocolate truffles sit at room temperature for 1 hour, and they were still a little bit runny. I couldn't work with them with my hands or anything. In fact, you probably wouldn't expect to work with them with your hands, but maybe with spoons or something. So I put them in the refrigerator, and I've waited probably an hour, hour and a half, a couple hours, I can't remember. It doesn't really matter, but I've checked on them occasionally. And when I noticed them beginning to stiffen up a little bit, I decided to get them out and start forming them into pieces that are the same size. Now, these aren't perfect balls, but I think I could work them right now. But my plan is to go ahead and fill this up and use another tray if I need to, and then let them refrigerate for a little while, and then I'll come and make them perfect balls by rolling them by hand, and I'll finish them and put them on a serving plate, and then we'll be done. So it's really an easy process. I'm using an ice cream scoop here. Well, it's really a very small scoop. Maybe I use it for something else, but I'm doing it to get the sizes equal, and you can see this is pretty stiff right now. But I fill it all the way to the top and scrape off any excess so that it looks like that. And then I take my spoon that I have to clean off sometimes, and then just go in and grab that amount and get it out and put it on parchment paper, which is lining a baking pan. And when you drop that, it won't be a pretty shape necessarily, but it will be the same size as all the others. And these don't have to be perfect, so if you miss getting a little from one side, it doesn't matter. So I'll just continue on this until I get all of these made into truffles, and then I will refrigerate them a little bit, and then we'll be back working them by hand. Now here's what we do next. I got this out of the refrigerator, and I've been working on these a little bit. I don't know if you can tell, but some of these are just the shapes that came out of the scoop, and others have been rounded off a little bit. So you want to take the ones that are ready to be worked on and try to make this into a round ball. Now it will make your hands dirty. That's why I would suggest that you get all of these balls put down here together before you try to dress them up. The actual method of dressing them up is to take the ball and put it in confectioner's sugar, which should be in some flat dish like this, and then once you have it finished, you put it over on your plate and you have your finished truffle. We'll have 20 of those, I think. So now I have my hand kind of messed up with confectioner sugar, so what I'm going to do is wash my hands, complete all of these, just putting them right back in the pan, and then I will start dipping them one by one, and I will have confectioner sugar on my hands, which is no problem at all, and complete the whole recipe. And I'll show you a picture of it in just a minute. Here are the finished dark chocolate truffles, and they don't look dark chocolate because they have the powdered sugar on the outside. I don't think I'm going to take a bite of one because it would be all over my teeth and I couldn't say anything after that. But I just hope you enjoy this recipe. It is really simple. It's not hard to put together. It has very few ingredients, and it seems Christmassy. It would be good for a gift. I hope you enjoy it.